Looking back at clips I didn't use in Blind Date, I found this one, which is funny. And this one, which is interesting, and I don't know why I never used it in the editing.
If you'd like to give us any more, you can find us here any night between the hours of 11 and 12, okay?
Goodbye, goodbye. La da 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 da. Excuse me, is there a bus from the house?
I also found some pin-up shots of Yvette Jarvis, today a candidate for city councilman in the city of Athens. The music in Blind Date was again by Stanley Myers, now my permanent composer, who in this movie collaborated with the multi-talented Richard Harvey. The songs were by John Congos, and in the Blind Date DVD, you'll find two of his best turned into music video clips, together with Stanley's main theme of Blind Date.
How? It's a bit rough.
Got some matches in my clothes.
Blind Date in its original version was shorter by some 10 minutes. Now, in the DVD version, we've put back all the omitted scenes, and I think it looks better this way.
How about when you're sober?
The movie won a prestigious award in Rome's Sci-Fi Festival and received some terrific reviews and some nasty ones, as it always happens all over the world.
I can't see your face well enough to prove it. But I know you're trying to hide your concern. Don't fret, Claire. I know what I'm doing, believe me.
Eat. The fish is getting cold.
This is the story of three kids.
Hi, I'm Bobby.
I'm V. Mick Swartz.
I'm Les Sherwood.
They thought the Greek islands were full of fun and games. So they got on a boat, off they went.
Wanna dance?
Oh, dance! No thanks. I'm not exactly in the mood.
Oh, come on! It'll be fun!
I'd love to dance.
Did you say I couldn't make a comeback? Did you say
they fell in love.
What other parts of your body are trained hard and impervious to pain?
Why? What'd you have in mind?
They don't call me head doctor for nothing.
Slept with a girl before.
There's always a first time, Lester.
Did you say I couldn't go the distance? And silver dreams would never stand resistance. Well, all your words have washed away like sand. And I won't deal with yesterday's confusion.
$20 a head.
$20 a piece. How's that?
And lost.
Mr. Boswell, we can explain this.
No need. I think I know already. You were set up, boys.
Why?
Obviously for that goddamn tape.
You mean they were KGB hookers?
They went through hell. Decided to spice up their lives.
Like head jobs?
Absolutely.
Take one more step and you'll get the biggest one of your life.
You see, the boys were after Skyhigh.
A guy was just shot for this tape, but I'm just gonna go with my plans, because I'm here for the fun and the women.
You can say that, Bobby?
Sort of, yeah.
Wait a minute. What do you think's on that tape?
a weird tape that made people go slack.
By now, as you listen to this tape, you must be as stunned as I was when I first came across the ultimate, most potent, hallucinogenic discovery in history. Unfortunately, I learned too late that my invention can do more than bring joy. Podnia Bershi can destroy the world.
The KGB were after the boys.
I don't believe it. That old guy dropped dead the minute he got near you. What'd you do? Fart?
The CIA were after the KGB.
You've got something we want, and we want it now.
And I was after the KGB and the CIA.
Let's make this pleasant. Where is Podnia Bershi?
What?
It's Russian for Skyhigh. Where is it?
And Sundance?
Go for the horses.
To make Skyhigh, I had learned my lesson in the world of independent movies. I had been screwed by unscrupulous foreign sales agents. I was owed money by a major independent. I had no accounting statements from a production company, and I didn't even own my work. So I took the big decision: make a movie where the writer, producer, director, financier, and 100% owner would be me, myself, and Omega. I was counting on the hefty commission from the sales of a package of films when I signed my actors and brought them to Greece. Unfortunately, the sale fell through, and I was left with my American Express, a good credit with local vendors, and a little cash, in the mercy of loan sharks and in the sympathy of friends. I was shooting during the day, raising money at night. But Skyhigh was made. We had tons of fun making it and splattered my favorite island, Mykonos, with eggs during the filming of this scene.
Thank you.
lot of freebies, like food and lodging on the cruise ship, which was also a free set. Poor Oceanus burned and sank many years later in Africa, so its celluloid images in Skyhigh can be considered a collector's item.
This stuff must be like dope.
From all the first-timers in this movie, Clayton Norcross became popular for his role in The Bold and the Beautiful a few years later.
Hey, girl! Slow down! I won't talk to you!
Listen, you like some fun?
What kind of fun?
Well, I have got a boat in the harbor, a real big one. You could go swimming, skinny dipping, anything.
You like head jobs?
Absolutely.
Take one more step, and you'll get the biggest one of your life.
Oh, God, don't shoot, please.
Don't follow us. Got it?
I'm becoming a fucking feminist.
Okay, I owe you a buck. Put it on my tab.
Before the movie was even edited, I took a promo reel that you have a chance to see versus the original theatrical trailer of the movie to MIFED, the annual film market in Milan. MIFED was a familiar ground, as it was there where I started my indie sales, training a newcomer in the business, fellow Greek Tom Skouras, who later went into domestic distribution, also forming Skouras Pictures. The feeding frenzy of video buyers that year helped me get enough advances to pay off the loan sharks, to return the money to my friends, and clear my American Express bills. Not only that, but I also got enough money to finish post-production and to buy songs from Chris DeBerg and Jackie DeShannon.
Fix me a drink, make it a strong one, hey comrade, a drink, make it a long one, my hands are shaking and my feet are numb, my head is aching and the bar's going round and I'm so down, in this foreign town, tonight there's a band, it ain't such a bad one, song, don't make it a sad one. I can't even talk to these Russian girls. The beer is lousy and the food is worse and it's so damn cold. Yes, it's so damn cold. I know it's hard to believe, but I haven't been warm for a week. Moonlight me up.
You sure?
I'm sure.
Okay, let's go.
Oh my God. This is totally awesome. I've got to record my impressions of this place. It's too much.
Let me leave you with the one and only word which must become your axiom if you're making independent movies. Dare. Yes, D-A-R-E, dare. If we didn't dare, there would never be an Acropolis scene in Skyhigh. The Archaeological Society, a stringent and unimaginative sort of authority in Greece, had turned down our application for filming on sacred land. Even if we did get a permit, the license fee would be too outrageous for our budget. We used the infallible approach, which is called cash. $150 to the guards at the Parthenon, and they let us discreetly sneak in, cameras and weapons, and here's the product of bribery. In the independent movie world, this is called stealing, and anyone who says, "I haven't done it," is a liar. But then again, lying is an integral part of indie filmmaking. I wouldn't have revealed this, but the statute of limitations has long expired. More stories to tell and more movies that I've made. Stories of flying three choppers in the National Park of Arches in Utah for Nightmare at Noon, our adventures in India for Bloodstone, and more. All these in part two in the next three DVDs of my collection. See you soon.
Hello!
Oh no. Get us out of here, Ben. Back!